What's up, guys? It's QGIS tutorial series, and today we're going to look at the plugin that is called Quick Map Service Plugin that is used in QGIS to achieve a number of tasks. And just a recap: in our last video, we looked at the HCMGIS plugin, which also is used to achieve a number of tasks. And if you are not able to look at it, you can check in the link in the description below. Otherwise, we'll just continue with checking out this other plugin, which is a cool plugin. So we'll just install it. For a tutorial on how to install the QGIS plugins, you can check on the QGIS documentation, or you can also check out in the previous video. So I've just searched for QMS and it has brought Quick Map Service, so it is not installed. Otherwise, it could be in the list of the installed plugins. So we are just going to install it, and just like the previous plugins, these are the details pertaining to the Quick Map Service, the developer and the homepage and all that, and the tags. So we're just going to install it. You need internet to download and install the plugin. So it has installed successfully. So we'll just close this. And if you look at the list of installed plugins, you can already see this Quick Map Service. And ensure that the checkbox is already checked so that it is active. So after we have installed it, it appears in this web, under the web menu. So we have, under web menu, we have Quick Map Services that was not there before. And then it has a number of menus down here. Alternatively, we also have the toolbar, this one, the Quick Map Service, and the search Quick Map Service, whereby you can search something, and it is docked on the, this is the dockable widget for Quick Map Service. So this is how it's layout in the QGIS. So we can choose to close this search, and if we want to see it, we can just use the button to activate and deactivate it. So we are going to open our plugin under web menu, Quick Map Service, and basically it can help us load base maps or web map services from different platforms. So one thing is that these are very few. There are only 5, as you can see here. So to increase to display all the services that Quick Map Services supports, we may need to go into the settings. And inside these settings, we have a number of items. We have the general tab, a number of tabs here, about 5 tabs that consist of different menus highlighting different functionalities or configuration. So we are going to navigate to more services, and there's a message here saying that contributed services definitions are provided as is, some disclaimer of sorts. And then since we want to display our multiple services, we'll click on this get contributed pack. And basically what it does, it tries to fetch those services. So after it has completed successfully, you'll see this message saying that the last version of contrib pack was downloaded. So you'll just click OK and ensure that you click save. And then after we have saved, what you are going to do, we are going to reload our plugin. And what you will notice is that now we have so many services listed here. So we have so many, a number of services that are listed here. And we have some of them, which are S3, Bing Maps. We have the OpenStreetMap. And even in OpenStreetMap, you can see we have a lot of services as well. One of the base maps, like S3, for example. And we will see that we have, if you look at S3 satellite, for example, It has loaded, and maybe we can zoom in this area for Africa. And if we further move into East Africa, you can see this is the base map. Then you can also look at the properties for one for this layer. And you can we notice that this is a map service. It's a web map service. It's tiled, so and it's being served from ArcGIS Online map server. So we can also check on other services. For example, the Bing. We can also look at the Bing satellite. Just disable this. So these are how the Bing satellite looks like. So they're more or less the same. Taking a little bit of time to load. So this is how it looks like. So we can also check other map services. CartoDB. So some services are also proprietary, so it depends. And then we can also check an example like for Yandex. So this is how Yandex looks like. You can notice the names here in Russian. And then, yeah, so we can load different base maps and use them as we please, or as depending on what we they use. So we also have the geofabric water. Yeah, it seems not to load. So the other things that we can do with the QuickMap service, we can enable the search. So basically you can use this to search web services. For example, we have some services from the Aeronautic Space Association, NASA. So you can load some layers from NASA. Yeah, so these are, you can check even the attribute tables. So this is just a random service that I've loaded here. So it's also in Russian. Then we can check on something else as well. Yeah, so due to probably the number of requests, you may have these information or these error. Yeah, so basically these are some of the things that you can use with QGIS, with the QuickMap service plugin. And you can use base maps for different items. So you can just take time and look at it. And you can also check about for the developers and everything. And we also have the settings whereby you can decide which, how many requests that it's doing and the timeout. You can also create groups. You can also add your own services, and then you can also change, enable and disable the services that you may want or you may not want. Yes, so that is it for this plugin. So click like and subscribe for more content on our channel.